guys and welcome back to another session of animal tissues. Yes guys, we are discussing about animal tissues, of which we have already completed the epithelial tissues of animal tissues and we started moving on to your muscles tissues. Yes, and in my last video we have already discussed the skeletal muscles. Today in this video we are going to discuss the second type of your muscles tissue, that is smooth or visceral muscles. Yes, today in this session we are going to discuss the second type of your muscular tissues, that is your smooth or visceral muscles. Yes, what is the second type of your muscular tissue? It is smooth or visceral muscles. Yes, so without further ado, let's get started with the smooth or visceral muscles. I know the very first question that is arising in your mind is, what is visceral muscles? Yes, why did it is named visceral muscles? So we are going to discuss it, why it is called visceral muscles, in the later part of the video. But before entering into the chapter, before knowing what are visceral muscles, let's move on to the structure and the characteristic features of your smooth muscles. Yes, simply you just remember what are smooth muscles. So let's study about the characteristic features of how is the smooth muscles. Yes, what is its structure? How does it appear? Which one, guys? Your smooth muscles. So characteristics. So first of all, the very first point is, these cells are spindle shaped. And as far as I remember, I have already explained you what is a spindle shaped structure. I told you, it is swollen in the middle and has got tapering ends. I will just show you in the board. Yes, this is a spindle shape. Yes, guys, are you all able to see it? So this is the spindle shaped structure which is pointed at the end and swollen in the middle. So your smooth muscles are pointed and has got tapering ends. Yes guys, so what we are going to discuss today? We are going to discuss about your smooth muscles. And what is the characteristic features of smooth muscles? Why it is called as your visceral muscles? The very first characteristic is that its shape. Yes, how is it? It is spindle shaped. And I have told you how the spindle shape looks like. Yes, it is swollen in the middle. Yes, are you all able to see it or not? It's swollen in the middle and pointed at the ends. Can you see this diagram? It's swollen in the middle and pointed at the ends. So this is what the spindle shaped structure of your smooth or visceral muscles. Done. Let's move on to the second point. Single and centrally located nucleus in each cell. Remember guys, in my skeletal muscles video, we discussed that they are multinucleated. Hope you guys remember it or not. I told you, skeletal muscle cells has got multiple nucleus. But, here is the contradictory is that the cells contains only single nucleus. Yes, the cells contains single nucleus. And where is this nucleus present? Exactly at the center. Exactly at the center, the nucleus is located. So what is the first point you have to write? First of all, it's a spindle shape that is tapering at both ends and it is uninucleated and it contains only single nucleus, and that single nucleus is located at the center of each cell. That means each cell has got only a single nucleus. Clear? Up to this clear? Now let's move on to the third characteristic features of your smooth muscles. So striation is absent. In case of smooth muscle, striation is absent. But remember guys, in case of your skeletal muscles, I told you striation is present. What exactly striation we discussed, guys? Yes, yes, you all are right. The alternate dark and light bands, which I already discussed in the last class. Yes, guys, the alternate dark and light bands are called striation, but in case of your smooth muscle, striation is absent. Yes, once again, I can show you what striation means. Yes, this is your dark band, light band, dark band. Dark band, dark band. So, this is the light band. Yes, the alternate dark and light bands are called as striation, and this striation is completely absent in case of your smooth muscles. But when we are going to compare it with skeletal muscles, in skeletal muscles, these alternate dark and light bands are present, but in case of smooth muscles, it is completely absent. Hope guys, you are clear with the third point. And what is the fourth characteristic features of this type of muscle is that it's unbranched. Yes, you can clearly see in this picture. Can you see any branches or outgrowth? And you very well know what branches means. Yes, you can see a tree. You can see a plant. Number of branches comes out from the trees. But here, when we are going to talk about your smooth muscle cells, here no branches are there. It's completely unbranched. So it's unbranched, slow. Yes, guys, slow. But when we are going to compare it with skeletal muscles, I told you skeletal muscles works very fast. But smooth muscles, these muscles are very slow at work. Yes, they works very, very slowly, and this will be clear while we are discussing, when we will discuss about the functions of smooth muscles. So remember, so these are slow by nature. They works very, very slow and they don't fatigue you. Yes, if you remember, I told you that the skeletal muscles gets easily tired, but these muscles, your smooth muscles, they don't easily get tired. They don't easily get fatigued. Yes, I hope you all are clear about the four points, four characteristic features of your smooth muscles. So once again, I'm going to summarize the things. Muscular tissues. The second type is called as your smooth or visceral muscles. So what is the first characteristic, guys? What is the first characteristic? Come on, you tell me. What is the first characteristic? Of course, it's spindle shaped. Smooth muscle cells are spindle shaped. Spindle shaped means tapering at both the ends. Done with the first point. Second one is your single nucleated. Means each cell contains only a single nucleus. And that nucleus is present exactly at the center of the cell. Second point clear? Third one, striation is absent. You know about striation, it's the alternate dark and light bands. So in case of your this smooth muscle, the striation is completely absent. The fourth and the last point is it's unbranched. No branches are at all seen in case of smooth muscles or visceral muscles. And it's very slow at work. Yes, it's very slow at work and don't get easily tired or fatigue you. Yes, so now let's move on to the other names. What are the different other names given to this smooth muscles? First of all, I can easily tell you. I told you striation is absent. Yes, striation is absent. So what can we call it? Yes, we can call it as unstriated muscles. So these smooth muscles can also be named as unstriated muscles. Why unstriated, guys? Because striation is absent. So unstriated muscles. So smooth muscles. First of all, the smooth muscles can also be called as unstriated muscles. Why unstriated muscles? Because striation is absent here. Yes. And found in visceral organs. Since these smooth muscles are found in your visceral organs. Viscerals mostly for the time being, you remember visceral organs means your internal organs. Yes, the organs present inside the body, visceral organs. Yes, And I can tell you, visceral organs means the organs which has got a cavity inside it, which has got a hollowness inside it, and such organs are called as your visceral organs. So what are visceral organs, guys? The organs present inside the body, first thing, and the organs has got hollow nature inside it, or cavity is present inside the organ. And if a cavity is present inside the organ, then such organs are called as visceral organs, and these smooth muscles are present, and these smooth muscles made up the visceral organs, and so it can be called as your visceral muscles. I hope you got to understand why we are going to call this is as a visceral muscles, because it is present in the internal organs, and the internal organs which has got a cavity, such organs are called as visceral organs, and this smooth muscles has made up these visceral organs, and hence we can also call it as visceral muscles. Yes, first we can call it as unstriated muscle because striation is absent. We can call it as visceral muscles because it is present in the visceral organs. Yes, and the third names, it is called as involuntary muscles. Can anyone tell me why it is called as involuntary muscles? If you guys remember, in the last video we discussed about voluntary muscles. Voluntary muscles means skeletal muscles. And I have given you the example of waving my hand. Yes, so that was under the moving of hand or waving of hand is under my control. So that's why we call that skeletal muscles as your voluntary muscles, because it was completely under my control, under our will. But these smooth muscles, these visceral muscles and this striated muscle is not under my control. Yes, my stomach is not under my control. Yes. Yes, my bronchi. What bronchi is, I will tell you. So what bronchi is not under my control. Yes, my esophagus is not under my control. My uterus is not under my control. So such muscles are called as your involuntary muscles. Yes, if I'm going to say my stomach do digestion right now, will it obey my order? No, of course not. Because it is not going to follow my rules and regulation. Yes, it does not work according to my will. So the muscles which does not work according to our will, such organs are called as your involuntary muscles. Yes guys, what are the three cute names for the smooth muscles? First of all, your striation is absent, so it is called as unstriated muscles. Since it is found in visceral organs, it is called as your visceral muscles. And since it doesn't work according to our will, it is called as your involuntary muscles. Hope you guys understood the names of these smooth muscles. Now let's see where exactly we can found. Where are these visceral organs? Yes, first I told you, stomach. Yes, the stomach has got a cavity inside it, so it's called as visceral organ. So in stomach wall, the stomach wall is made up of your smooth muscles. Yes, then your large intestine, small intestine, remember guys, large intestine, small intestine walls are made up of smooth muscles. Yes, then bronchi. I told you what bronchi is. Yes, so see, we have got the windpipe. The windpipe is also called as trachea, through which the exchange of gases takes place in human body. Trachea is there. So this trachea, when enters into the lungs, yes, it divides into number of tube-like structure, and that tubes are called bronchiae or bronchioles. Yes, from the nostril, we are taking and inhaling and exhaling the oxygen or carbon dioxide. And thus, gases enters into our body through the windpipe, and that windpipe can also be called as trachea. So when the trachea enters into the lungs, yes, it divides to form number of tube-like structure, and that tube is called bronchi or bronchioles. And this bronchi is made up of your smooth muscles. So your stomach walls are made up of smooth muscles. Your small intestine walls are made up of smooth muscles. Large intestine walls are made up of smooth muscles. Your esophagus is made up of smooth muscles. Yes, your bronchi is made up of smooth muscle. Your uterus Yes, the uterus walls are also made up of smooth muscles. Your eyes walls are also made up of your smooth muscles. And actually, what this smooth muscle helps in? This smooth muscles helps in peristalsis. Yes, what is the main function? What is the function of these smooth or visceral muscles? It helps in peristalsis. What exactly peristalsis is? Simply, I'm going to tell you that whenever we are taking a food, when we are taking a food inside our mouth, it moves through the food pipe. We all know that. The food travels through the food pipe. But how does it travels? Yes, it travels through the food pipe or esophagus. That esophagus shows a rhythmic movement. Yes, a wave-like movement. A wave-like movement is shown by the esophagus. Yes, and that wave-like movement is called peristalsis. And this peristalsis is possible only because of your smooth muscles. So what is the main function of your smooth and visceral muscles? It helps in peristalsis. Again, peristalsis takes place in stomach for digestion purpose. Yes, guys, I hope you understood the characteristics and the various names given to the smooth muscles and where exactly we can find the smooth muscles and what is the main function. What is the main function? Peristalsis. I hope you are clear about your smooth muscles and visceral muscles. Now let's move on to the third type of your muscular tissue, which is cardiac muscles. Yes, now let's discuss about cardiac muscles. So guys, now let's move on to the third type of your muscles tissue, that is the cardiac muscles. From the name itself, you can easily understand. Cardiac muscles means, yes, exactly, it is present in the heart. Yes, our heart muscles are made up of your cardiac muscles. So let's see what are the characteristic features of these cardiac muscles. The first thing, the fibers are cylindrical in shape. Just go back and remember, guys, we have read in skeletal muscles. They were also cylindrical in shape. Yes, so here also the cardiac muscles are cylindrical in shape. Can you see this picture? Yes, these are cylindrical in shape, isn't it? So these cardiac muscles and these cells or these fibers are exactly cylindrical in shape. The first point, yes, it's very clear. It is cylindrical in shape and it's uninucleated. Yes, how many nucleus are present in each cell, guys? Single nucleus is present. It's uninucleated. Striations are present. Just like the skeletal muscles, the alternate dark and light bands. Yes, the cardiac muscles has got these alternate light and dark bands, which is nothing but your striation. Hence, striation is present in case of your cardiac muscles. But it was absent in? Come on, let me know in the comment section where it was absent. Yes, come on, tell me where it was absent. In smooth muscles. In visceral muscles, striation was absent, but in skeletal muscle and in this cardiac muscle, your striation is present, which is nothing but the alternate dark and light bands pattern. So here, it's uninucleated, striation is present, cylindrical in shape, and the fibers are branched. Yes, the fibers are branched here, guys. Can you see these branches? Yes, just like the branches of a tree. So these are the branches. So these cardiac muscles are branched structure, are branched cell. So these fibers are branched, striations are present and don't fatigue you. Yes, don't fatigue you means it's not going to get up tired easily. Yes, just we have studied in case of your skeletal muscles, they get easily tired. Yes. But in case of your visceral muscles, they don't get easily get tired. Here also the cardiac muscles, they don't fatigue you. They don't get tired easily. So what are the characteristic features you need to remember in case of your cardiac muscles? First thing, cylindrical in shape, done. Branched, done. Cells, uninucleated. Striation, present. So now let's see the various names given to this cardiac muscles. The very first thing is that since it is present in heart, it is called as your cardiac muscles. Yes, the very first and the common name is cardiac muscle since it is present in the heart. Yes, and since striation is present, what we can call, guys? Come on, let me know in the comment section. If striation is present, that muscles can be called as striated muscles. Yes, that muscles are called as your striated muscles. Again, it's not under our control. It doesn't work according to our will. I'm not going to give command to heart. Yes, I can't give command to heart that heart start pumping right now. Will it obey my order? Of course not. So it works not according to our will. Yes, it doesn't follow our will. So it's not under the control of our will. So we can call it as involuntary muscles. Yes, so what are the three names given to this cardiac muscles? Is the first one is your only present in heart. So it is called as cardiac muscles. Striation is present. So it is called as striated muscles. And since its work are not under the control of our will, it is called as involuntary muscles. And we all know the functions of the heart. What is the function of the heart? Pumping blood throughout our body. And how does the heart pumps the blood? By contraction and relaxation. Contraction and relaxation. And that contraction and relaxation is possible because of this cardiac muscle. Once the heart gets contract and relaxation, the blood is pumped through the blood vessels and supplied to the entire body parts. Yes. Once again, I'm going to summarize the cardiac muscles characteristic. The fibers are cylindrical in shape, uninucleates, branched. Striation is present. Since striation is present, it is called as striated muscles. It's only present in heart. So it is called as cardiac muscles. It doesn't work according to our will. So it's called as involuntary muscles. And it helps in contraction and relaxation of the heart, which helps in pumping the blood. Blood moves through the blood vessels and supplied to the entire body. Hope guys you understood the muscles tissue, all the three types of muscles tissues. And the coming video, we are going to discuss the third type of animal tissues. Until then, revise at home and stay safe at home.